so much for staying overtime. My name is Palacher and I work for the Lowell Public Schools as an English language program coordinator for the district. And so I represent elementary all the way to high school. And what we do, or what I do in my role, is to ensure that we provide services and programs and instruction that are accessible to our English language learners. And so my role evolves a lot, a great deal, in providing professional development opportunities to teachers to ensure that they are able to interact and make connection with students and be able to provide them with relevant education. So I was very honored and appreciative of the opportunity to travel to Cambodia with a group of educators from elementary all the way to college level. And I'm very honored and appreciative of hearing all the presentation that took place today and how impactful your study tour to Cambodia have reached and been able to connect with students and transform your curriculum and instruction. So I just wanted to begin my presentation by sharing with you, you know, the rationale and purpose of our study tour, and basically to expand our knowledge as educators and be able to reflect our learning and be able to draw the history and the culture and the experience being right there on site, and then be able to bring all that we learn and all that we experience back into the classroom. So that's the rationale and purpose of our trip. And we do that in order to better understand the culture of students in front of us and be able to make connections with them and be able to utilize their prior experience, their prior knowledge, their culture and history into the classroom and make education relevant and engaging to them. So what we try to do as educators in the Lowell Public Schools, because we're such a very diverse district, we have 65% of our students that speak another language when they come to us. And so they bring a very rich and diverse experience and culture to our classrooms. And as teachers, we have to be prepared and be able to adjust and accommodate our lessons and our instructional styles so that we would be able to reach students better. So this is a sample of classrooms in Cambodia, very different from our classroom. And what they use as their strategies in Cambodia are quite different from how we reach out to our students and provide our lessons, is that their resources are lacking, as we've learned from many of our presentations here. So they have to adapt and adjust. And many of their classrooms are at 50 or 60 students. And the teachers, they share their knowledge by basically doing presentation lectures, or they provide lessons by writing on the board and then have students copy. And that's their instruction style. And that's how students learn, is by copying, reading, and sharing. And that's how students learn, is through lecture, and not have many opportunities to do a lot of hands-on work. So when students from that culture enter our classroom, we have to be able to do, you know, we expect them to behave a different way to learn in our classroom. We expect them to be active learners. We expect them to participate. We expect them to raise their hands, and we expect them to take charge and be responsible for their learning. So it's quite different. And then we also try to teach them to be independent learners. When they come from a culture that uses a lot of interaction and a lot of sharing and a lot of group work, we're expecting them to be independent. And so, you know, when we go to different countries to study the culture and history, you know, we want to also, as educators, learn how students learn in the classroom and be able to bring that knowledge back into our classroom so that we can adapt and or understand or be able to prompt students to behave a certain way. Because we have to be very explicit in teaching, because the students that are new in the country or in the city, especially the new refugees that are being resettled in Lowell, they have to learn how to sit down. They have to learn how to use a pen or a pencil or how to use textbooks or technology. And we have to be very explicit, because where they come from, the materials may not be very familiar to them. They're coming from a very informal situation into a very formal classroom. So we have to be able to adapt. And so these are some of the rationale behind the needs of learning the cultures and learning the history of students, because we want to be able to appreciate and acknowledge and be able to validate. Now, I came here to the US as a refugee myself at a very young age, and I've never had any formal education prior to coming. So when I arrived as a 9-year-old and being placed in fourth grade, the teachers didn't know who I was or where I had come from or what I had experienced. And I didn't know how to make, I was disconnected for a great part of my career as a student in the US. And I didn't get to learn about my culture and my history until I was in college, enrolling in a Vietnam War class to learn, right? So, you know, when I sat there listening to your presentations, I was so proud. I wish I was in your class, you know, back in elementary or back in middle school or back in high school, because I would have learned so much about my culture and my history and be able to appreciate my my identity. You know, I'm getting very emotional here, but you know, it took me all the way to college to be able to learn about that part of the world and to hear that we as educators are reaching out so much and try to be responsive to our students and our families. And I'm just so proud, you know, to be here with all of you. And so, you know, with my experience traveling with all of you and different educators, I want to be able to share this professional development with the educators in Lowell Public Schools, because 14 of us went. So 14 of us can do so much to reach out to our colleagues. And I want to be able to establish a structure in the Lowell Public Schools that we are able to continue to share and be responsive educators. And so I, my last trip, not this past trip that I went with you, but my previous trip, I was able to purchase this silk that really demonstrate how silk is made. And my interest in silk is immense. And I want to be able to teach a course on silk making. Teaching about culture and history through the art of silk making. So that's my, you know, hope for the future for Lowell Public Schools, is to be able to teach the history and the culture and the tradition of Cambodia through the art of silk making. Because through this one piece of cloth, you could see so much and how silk is done from the silk, the bottom there, as you could see, and then feeding, taking care of the worms by giving them mulberry leaves, and then collecting the silk, weaving the silk, and then selling silk in the market. So with this one piece of cloth, you can learn a great deal from about the culture and tradition of Cambodia. So my hope as an educator in the Lowell Public Schools and as the coordinator of the English Language Education Department is to ensure that not only do we learn about Cambodia and teach about Cambodia and the culture of Cambodia, but also extend our reach to the new refugees that are being resettled in Lowell as well. So, that's about it. I've spoken to all of these, and there are some activities that we can do to connect with our students, and I can share this PowerPoint with you as well. Is applying some of the activities in your classroom to build relationships, to get to know your students and your neighborhoods, and sharing personal stories and narration, and being mindful of students' culture always by sharing your own personal story and your own personal interests as well. And here are some of the references I use. Well, thank you so much.